From the Windy City here in Chicago, Illinois, he's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Two teams pretty evenly matched here. Ray, any final thoughts?
Well, I kind of laughed as I heard both benches here talk about, oh, we got to get the first goal. Well, somebody's not going to get it. That doesn't mean the game's over. But I think it's really important to try and play the game at the pace you want to play. These two teams don't play the same style.
Both teams seem ready, and they are about to drop the puck on this opening faceoff. The Blackhawks start with possession as we are now underway. Moves it quickly over to Anderson. Shuts him down. And things start to ramp up a little bit now on the ice with that play. Read perfectly with the stick at center by Taves. Gets control of the puck here in his own end. Right up the gut into the attacking zone. Quick pass to Shabbat. Pass back to the point. That goes off a twig. Gets a hold of the puck from the right side. Shot with the stop.
Sogard's able to angle that.
He scores! Jonathan Taves!
I don't know if this is the hardest shot ever, but this is a quick release. Beats the goalie low glove side.
The Blackhawks take a 1-0 lead here early in this first period.
What a way to crank up the crowd. You get yourself on the board early.
Puck is dropped and we are back underway. He's got a step. Oh, what a save!
Really good effort. I thought it made a good play on the net, but the goaltender's right on top of it.
Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. DeBrincat's going to play it to the corner. Receives the pass. Here's a short pass to Shabbat. Right in the slot. And that banks off a stick. He scores! That's how you do it. Leadership to a T. The captain capitalizes.
A quick flick of the wrist and that snapshot beats the goaltender. He's in the low slot. He doesn't have much time to think about it.
From that puck battle, it was able to go on and score there. That's his no contest superstar ability, and that tenacity makes him such an effective player.
Puck is dropped and play resumes. From one point man to another. Too many bodies in the way. Carries it across the line. Snaps it on net. The Senators have it now. Manages to hang on. And now it's over to Patterson. And they fail to go tape to tape. And just like that comes up with the puck. Great little flick of the stick. Sogard's gonna slow things down and up for the whistle.
Well, you gotta kill the play eventually. That way everyone can get reorganized.
James and Ray with you tonight. More than half the period has been played. We got a tie game. Chicago's won the draw and they'll go to work. Got eyes on the play. Right out in front. And there's another stop.
I love the way that he's in position and he's got the reflexes to bang out a couple of stops in a row.
There's a hit on the play. The Blackhawks look to start the transition game. Streaking into the attacking zone for the right. Look out. Stopped by the goaltender. Poked away in the defensive end. Quick pass across to Norris. Looking to set up offensively. Slides it back to the blue line. Gains the zone on the left wing. They go on the attack through center. The Blackhawks take it along the wall. Oh, he caught him!
Did he ever. Head down, right into the train tracks. Pretty good shot. The goalie's able to get the blocker up on it and put it outside.
DeBrincat's known for scoring when he shoots while still in motion. His make-it-snappy zone ability helps him get his shot off before the goalie can catch up to it. Jones intercepts passes to transition the play, guys. That's his quick pick zone ability, and it's how he can regain possession. Look out for one of these players to be a big factor in tonight's game. James and Ray, back to you.
And the always popular icing call made, and you know what that means, Ray.
An offensive zone faceoff, man. He missed the play going down the ice, and that's a gimme icing. Now they can't change. You've got tired guys on the ice.
Getting into the later stages of this period, we are all tied up in this one. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone.
You can be a little more aggressive here. You know the other team's tired. They just want to get the puck and clear the zone.
Moves it over to Johnson. Moves the puck into the attacking area. Makes the save. There's the whistle as things will slow down here for a moment.
Always a good play if you're not sure what's going on. Freeze the puck. Stalock's taking a look up at the big board on the replay. He'll see his stick save was excellent. That was a good scoring chance.
Jones reads the play so well, and when he intercepts passes, he can turn the play around in his favor, guys. We call that his quick pick zone ability, and it's how he can create something out of nothing.
And there's the horn concluding period number one as both teams get on the board. Both teams heading down the tunnels. We'll take a quick breath ourselves and be back for the second period. All right, I think my partner in crime, Ray Ferraro, is rested and refreshed. Along with the teams, we're ready to get things underway. Been a fun one so far. Neither side giving an inch. Still tied here as we open things up in the second. One period already in the books. Ray, how have you seen this thing? Puts it in for the go-ahead goal!
Control the game now. You finally got the lead. You've worked so hard to get in front. Don't give it up now. I like how quickly he got this puck off his stick in the high slot. He moved around, find some clean ice, and then beat the goaltender.
The Blackhawks taking one goal lead here in the second.
This game doesn't look like it's going to stretch out at all now, James. Even though there is a lead, it seems like it'll stay close.
Kind of lost control for a second there, but regains possession. Great chance in front. Can't get it to click. Here's a shot. Stopped by the goaltender. There's another for the hit parade. Cuts to the front. Oh, what a blocker stop on that.
Really good work. I like this chance here as they get the puck into a scoring spot. Goalie's just better on this time. Those are the types of hits that the game was built upon. It's legal, it's hard, it's right through the body. That is a perfect hit.
Lots of time left in this period. Chicago's got a one-goal lead. And now he tries to get it across to DeBrincat. The Senators looking against the half wall. Big save. Murphy's got the puck in his own zone. From center, they get into the attacking area. Ottawa's moving it up the ice. Angles it over to Tkachuk. Bats the puck right out of midair. Chicago's got it along the wall. Odd man rush. What a break for the goalie as it goes off both posts.
Blackwell's rung a couple of shots off the post already. I can't believe he's not so frustrated right now.
Tenorti's got it in the defensive end. From the right side, they gain the zone. Here's a shot, and makes the save. There's another stop.
Quick reflexes give him the opportunity to make back-to-back stops.
with possession along the wall. Moves it to Tkachuk. Things starting to get a little physical out there. The Blackhawks take it across the line. Here's a shot. Oh, what a stop. And the intensity starting to ramp up here after that hit. The Senators gain control of the puck. Moves it on over to Patterson. Snaps it onto the net. Too much congestion blocks the shot. Down the right side and into the zone. Let's it go from the slot. Oh, what a save in front.
These are frustrating. You don't get many chances like this. I thought he made a good shot, but the goalie, an excellent stop, beats the shooter.
He scores!
They didn't sit back after getting that first one. They pile a back-to-back goal on here. Now coaches talk about getting to the front of the net, make it difficult on the goalie, take his eyes away. Man, he only could see the player's butts in front of him. He can't even see the puck.
The Blackhawks have made their way back to center ice with now a little breathing room, a two-goal lead late in the second.
After the initial rush on the bench, the coach was down and back on the bench, reminding everybody, don't take it.
He scores! What a counterpunch!
Well, their coaches have to be thrilled with this. They got up off the deck and scored shortly after giving one up. I think the goaltender's got to do a better job. There's only one player in front of him. He's got to look around him, find them where the puck is. He never picks it up until it's past him.
The Senators have narrowed the gap here late in this second period. Some momentum for them now.
Now they want to close this period off well, get themselves into the third with a chance to get back into it.
Quick feed to Edwin. And serves up a little knock on the play. Ottawa's got it in their own zone. Slides the puck to Patterson. Looks to set up at the point now. The Blackhawks gain possession along the wall. Sends it ahead to Anderson. Takes the pass. I couldn't see who's going to play it against the half wall. Big time stop there. From point blank, he scores! This is like the hockey equivalent of a buzzer beater, eh?
Yeah, it didn't look like there was going to be enough time. The puck's in the net, and now they feel really good about themselves going into the next period. He's tight to the net. He doesn't have much time. And that snapshot beats the goaltender from the low slot.
Chicago's made their way back to center ice. What's the message here as they take a two-goal lead late here?
Don't change anything. Stay aggressive. Get the puck deep. Be really sure if you're going to pass it through the middle of the ice.
Don't go anywhere. Third period is coming up, and it's coming up next. Two down, one to go. Third period, they're ready to drop the puck. Here we go, put up or shut up for both teams here in this third period. We are underway. Ray Ferraro is back down at ice level. Ray, 40 minutes played so far. What's been your assessment of this tilt?
Ottawa's first two periods have been marred by turnovers. Every time it looks like they're going to get something going, they burp up another one. They don't have the puck much, and they're behind in the game.
Knocked away. Chase right in front. And the goaltender comes up with a piece of it to keep it out of the net.
Sometimes you make a good shot and you just get beaten by the goaltender. I'd say that's one that you put in that category.
Takes the feed. Hammers one. And a great save. Slammed into the wall. Off the outside of the iron. So Bogaerts going to hang on for a whistle here in the third.
Well, there's not much time left here as you get into the final 20 minutes. The game's close. A mistake now would be critical. Even though that puck is delivered with great velocity, that looked like a pretty easy stop for the goalie to make.
Plenty of playing time left in this frame. It's 4-2. Giroux won the draw deep in the defensive zone. Ottawa's in transition. At center ice now, he grabs the puck. Here's a shot, and there's a save. Chicago's got the puck. To the low slot. Nice save from point-blank range.
Yeah, he looked up to the roof after that one. He thought he had room. The goaltender makes the stop.
He scores! And that's two in a row!
Get one, you stay hungry, you want to stay on your toes, and while the defending team's back on their heels, they throw another one on the board. When the goaltender gets into the butterfly, he's just trying to take away as much of the net as he can. He's got lots covered, not enough as he gets beaten for a tally.
Chicago's goal-scoring abilities have been on full display so far this evening and here in the third.
Really impressive display. They've moved the puck well, skated, really forecheck. Well, there's really nothing they haven't done tonight.
Ottawa's got it along the wall. And that's off a stick. Sensational stop by Staloff. Into the offensive end now. Takes a wrist shot. It scores!
They get one and you think that the game's going to flatten out, but it doesn't. They pile two more after that. That's a good shot. He zips it by the goaltender, but he works himself into a clean area on the ice to shoot this from the high slot.
And they're going to change goalies.
He can't get over to the bench quick enough. Now he can get rid of that mask, throw in a ball hat, wrap a towel around his neck, and try and relax. This has been a rotten night for him.
Chicago's all smiles on the bench next to you, aren't they?
Yeah, they're having lots of fun. Not so much on the other side where this night has been a nightmare.
Moves it quickly over to Johnson. Lets it fly. Gets a glove on it to make the stop.
So good. A couple of quick stops keep the puck out.
From the slot, wrist shot. Stopped by the goaltender. Hangs onto the puck. Slides it to Patterson. Nice pass. Here's a shot. And there's a great save by Staloff. Into the offensive zone. Quick shot.
Wow.
Off the post and in the net. They score.
He beat him with the quick release there, James. That thing hits the post, sure, but it's his release that gets that puck away too quickly for the goalie. I think this goalie's going to look up at the clock and see just exactly how much time is melted away. It's going from bad to worse for these guys.
Chicago's only continued to extend the lead here in the third.
They haven't missed many chances. They've scored at will and now are coasting home.
Handles the puck. Passes right to the front. Scores! Well, they haven't given up just yet.
No, but there's still a long road to go, James, before they can realistically think that they're back in this game. But you get one, maybe you get another one quickly, and you can turn the tide.
The Senators still have a lot of catching up to do, but they have something to build on now.
Yeah, they do, and I think what they can look forward to is the buzzer is closer to the end of the game.
Went there, huh? Here comes the pushback.
Giroux's ready to go. Apparently, the other guy doesn't want anything to do with him.
Quick pass to Jones, and no luck on that pass attempt. Oh, that's got the crowd buzzing after that stop. Great defensive effort with the stick. From the left side, they gain the zone. And that's knocked aside with the stick by Radish. Inside of the final minute here in the third. Grabbed along the boards by Jones. That's blocked by Talbot. And as he opts to freeze the puck, we get a whistle.
Starting to look like a little bit of a fire drill in the zone, so this is a good play.
Check in with our own Carlin Bave. Who had the better night in that head-to-head matchup with the Stars?
Jones has been in the middle of it offensively, and I've really liked his game. I think he's been the better player in this matchup, guys.
Move to the middle! Oh, if there's going to be a regret in this one, that might be it.
Yeah, that play is right there to be had. They just missed the pass. The scoring chance goes away.
Some solid defensive work in their own end with the poke check. Looks to pass it, and on the heels of that big hit, he's being called out. Here we go.
Yeah, your star player gets hit like that. Somebody's better step up for him. And he challenges them, and now they're going to go.
Oh, and he hammers him and sends him down to the ice.
That's a clear decision there. Too little, too late. You get in a fight, but your team has just gotten their lunch handed to them.
This is where you almost wonder if there's run time available.
I hope so.
I think they found the tooth that was lost, and both teams now back inside the faceoff circle. And play resumes as the puck is dropped. Scooped up along the wall by Hamonic. Sends it over to Giroux. Ottawa's got the puck against the half wall. Pow in the open ice.
You think you've got a lane? It is closed off.
Here's a shot. Log jam in front. That's broken up. And the puck sails out of play and will get a faceoff while one lucky fan gets a memory of a lifetime.
Giroux's able to get everything behind this hit. He really lays one on here.
Centers are set, faceoff ready to resume play. Chicago's won the faceoff. Puck scooped up by Blackwell. Dishes it to DeBrincat. Ottawa's probably going to look at this one and say, we were the better team. Unfortunately, they just don't get the W.
Now, sometimes the numbers on that big board over center ice matter more than anything else. That's the case tonight.
They talk about wanting to have more fun in the sport. This is a perfect example of that step forward.
Well, when the players started saluting the fans, you could almost feel like the connection between the two of them started to increase. I think it's a great thing to do, and look how much fun everybody's having.
And that'll do it for Ray Pearl. I'm James Cebulski. Thank you.